scripture will come from Ephesians, the 6th chapter, 11 through 17. And it goes as such. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil days of having all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girded about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye may be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God.
All right.
And after reading these 7 verses of the chapter 6 of Ephesians, this message has to be titled, "You Are Equipped." Amen. You are equipped. And then after reading this over and over and over, first of all, I want to thank God for giving me this honor to speak, and the pastor afforded me this opportunity. I also like to thank my wife, girlfriend, and my secret lover, Iris, Michelle, and Rico, who have to put up with me. Amen. But back in 1973, I joined the Army. I like to walk. I joined the Army in 1973, and in the Army, I had to take an oath, I had to take a physical to make sure that my physical body and my mental mind was ready to deal with what they had to give me. I had to take this oath to swear that I was going to protect the United States of America from all enemies, anyone that want to hurt the freedom that we have today. And in my training, I was trained on different sorts of weapons, how to take them apart, put them back together, make sure that they were clean, operational. I also was trained in chemical warfare, how I had to don on an outfit to protect myself from chemical or any other things such as that matter. I also had to learn how to use my hand just in case I dropped my weapon or whatever the case may be. I had to learn how to protect myself no matter what the case was. And I also learned how to camouflage myself. I could be right here and the enemy right there, but they wouldn't be able to see me because I was right there, blending in with the background. So in the Army, I was trained so I can, do what I had to do to protect my country and to protect myself. And here it is, now that I've been out of the Army for a while and I'm in a new phase of my life, I have been changed from a military soldier protecting the United States of America to now a member of South Calvary Missionary Baptist Church, where I play a new role where there is a spiritual warfare going on. And in a spiritual warfare, I had to give my life to Christ. And when I did that, I had to come forward and I had to confess, as the Bible said, with my mouth and believe in my heart that Jesus died and he rose on the 3rd day. I also had to believe that there's a Trinity, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And then I also believe that there was only one Lord, training in the church, I had to go through a new members class because it's telling me about the history of the church, what the church believed in, and these things I need to know. I had to be up under the preached word because I need to hear the word of God. What good is it being saved if I don't hear the word? So I need to hear that preached word. I had to go to Sunday school because Sunday school gives me the opportunity to where I can raise my hand and ask questions about things if I don't know them. And it's also the same way when you go to Bible study. So what I'm saying is that if you are saying that you believe in our Lord Jesus Christ, you will stay up under the word of God. You will be taught the word of God, and you will deliver the word of God. So I'm here to tell you that in this letter that was written by Paul, where he's in prison, I would have to say that I want to run through Ephesians, give you a little brief on it, because I'm going to tell you something about Paul. I don't care what Paul's situation was. Paul loved the Lord. And he was more worried about your salvation than his own. So Paul, whether he was in prison or out of prison or under house arrest, he still spoke the word of God. He didn't care whether you were Pilate or a prison guard. He wanted you to know who Jesus Christ was. And if you read the book of Ephesians, you understand that chapter 1 tells us about our position in Christ, that we are in Christ Jesus. When you say that we are in Christ, he talks about that we are blessed in Christ Jesus. Yes, 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 we are blessed in Christ Jesus. And then he tells us, go on to let us know that there is hope in Christ Jesus. So you need to understand that if you read chapter 1, okay? Chapter 2 tells us about the heavenly places, that we are made alive in Christ Jesus and created in Christ Jesus. We are built in Christ Jesus. Chapter 2. So now you understand that where we are. Now you're going to go to chapter 3, and that's the revelation of the mystery. Paul wants you to know that a mystery was once hidden from us, the Gentiles, and it is now revealed. We get to enjoy Jesus Christ as the Jews have. His task as a minister was to let us know these things, because a lot of them didn't realize that they can be a part of Jesus Christ. And he had a prayer to help us, enable us to know that we are. Chapter 4 tells us that we need to walk. We need to walk humbly with all lowliness and meekness. When you agree that we need to walk that way, we need to walk lovingly, long-suffering, forbearing one another in love. Wouldn't you say we need to do that? Yes, we need to actually read and understand where God is telling us, because he gave us this book. It is full of instructions of life. He says that it is our basic instruction before leaving this earth. We need to know this while we're on this earth. And he tells us to walk peacefully. Keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. Isn't that so simple for us to do? Don't y'all agree with it, because it's hard for us. Chapter 5 tells us to walk worthy of our calling. So we ought to walk in love. We ought to walk in the light. And we should be walking carefully, because you never know who is out there watching you. Because your walk may save somebody's life. So now we get to the chapter that you are equipped in. Chapter 6 is where God equips you for the battle by having you put on the whole armor. It didn't tell you to put on a piece as you need it, because that's what some of us do. We put it on piece at a time according to what's going on in our life at that time. But the Bible tells us to put on the whole armor. It didn't tell you to wear this on Wednesday and wear that one on Thursday. You need to know that and seven nights after our joints that we need to put our work on. No. You need to wear that armor 24/7, 365 days a year, because it will keep you from going that way. We need to understand that you need the girdle of truth. You need to know God's truth, because the devil lies can sound like the truth.
Yes.
See, if you weak in the mind, he can tell you anything if you do not know the word of God. You need the shoes of readiness to bear the gospel. You must always, always, always be ready to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. You need that breastplate of righteousness, which will protect your vital organs, your heart. Your heart that blood pumps the blood through your veins. You need to protect anything and everything that's vital to you. You need to understand what the shield of truth is all about. The shield will block you from the spears of temptation. Those you thought was your friends may not be your friends. You need to understand that the helmet of salvation, it will protect your mind. The devil will put things in your mind that may make you think that you are holy of the holiness. It may make you think that you are the preacher of all preachers, and that no one can teach better than you. No other deacon can pray like you. You are the best singer that the choir ever had, and the ministry cannot run without you. You need to wear that helmet of salvation to keep your mind in God's hand. You must understand that some people carry their sword in their hand. Some of them carry it in their car. But you know, when the devil attacks you, you can't find the scripture, because you left it here and you left it there. And the devil can throw some quick word on you and tell you anything. That's why you must have God's word buried deep within your heart. No other place but in your heart. Amen. Amen. Let me tell you something. While I was in the Army, you know, the United States, in World War II, they dropped this bomb on Nagasaki, you know, Japan, and it just wiped out everything for miles and miles. Well, let me tell you something. The devil has a bomb just like that too. He has three major weapons that he uses against you. He used deception.
All right.
Yes, you can easily be deceived. Because let me tell you something, how easily you can be deceived. I look like Mr. Brown. A lot of y'all think it is. Listen to the preached word. We must start coming.